Dear students, I welcome you again to the online video class of computers. I'm Meenakshi Kothiyal, your computer teacher. Children, so far we have completed our chapter. Now, one more important announcement is there that your exams, second term exams, are going to start from 14th of December. Okay, from Monday onwards. So, children, your syllabus will come from 15th assignment to 25th assignment. Okay, this is your syllabus, that whatever I have taught you in my 15th to 25th assignment, that all will come in your exam. So you have to practice hard and you have to study more at your home. Okay, children. So till now we have done with the chapter. Now in this video, I'll be going to discuss the question answers of the chapter. Okay, children. So for this, you have to take out your book. So children, this is your chapter number 7, Features of File Management. Today we are going to solve the question answers, only the objective part of this chapter. Okay children, so for this you have to take out page number 116. Okay, here are given the exercises questions. Objective part, question number 1. Fill in the blanks. First one, dash is a location on the hard disk to store information. Now children, what is there which is used to store the information in the form of files in the computer system? Yes, folder. So folder is a location where the information is stored in the form of files. Okay. Second, information is stored in the form of a dash in a folder. As I've told you, that information is stored in the form of files in a folder. Okay. Third, organization of file or folder is referred to as file dash. When we organize a file or folder in a systematic way, that is referred as file management. So, write down management. Okay, children. Fourth one. Making duplicate copy of a file or folder is termed as dash. When we make any duplicate copy or more than one copy of the same file, that is known as copy a folder. That term is known as copy a folder. Fifth one, dash refers to transfer of a file or folder to another location. So, moving a file. Okay. Moving a file. When we move a file, it refers to as shifting or transferring a file folder to another location. Okay, children. Now, come to the next question. Question number 2. Write whether the following statements are true or false. Okay, now we will read out the statements here and then we'll find out that whether they are true or false. 1. Deleted file folders can be restored from the recycle bin. As we all know that whenever we delete any file or folder, that goes to recycle bin. Okay. Now, if we have mistakenly deleted it, we can restore it from the recycle bin also. So, this statement is true. Right and true. Okay, children, written. Now, come to the second part. File management refers to various calculations. No, children. It does not refer to calculation. It refers to organization of file folders. Okay. Organization of files.
So this statement is false. Come to the third one. A file can even be tampered if it is password protected. Yes, children, sometimes what happens? A hacker which can hack the password if you have not put any strong password, then it could be tampered. Tampered means it could anyone can open your file, interrupt in your file without your permission. Okay, so sometimes it happens. Yes, if it is not password, if it is password protected, even also your file can be tampered. So we have to take care that we have to change our password time to time. So this statement is true. Okay. Fourth, moving a file is done by cut and paste operation. Yes, children, this statement is true. If you want to move any file or shift any file from its location to another location, we have to click on the options like cut and paste. Okay, so moving a file means cut and paste. Next comes fifth part. Unauthorized handling creates file tampering. Yes, children, unauthorized means without permission. If you are touching any file, or if you are opening it, editing on it without the permission of a owner, then it creates file tampering. So unauthorized means without permission. So this statement is also true. Now here comes question number 3. Give an appropriate name for the following tasks. First part, removing a file folder. Children, if you want to remove a file folder, means we have to delete it. So, deleting. So, the appropriate name for this task is deleting. Okay. Next, second, an unauthorized act of manipulating, corrupting a file. Manipulating means editing, okay, without permission of the owner. So that refers to tampering a file. Okay, that refers to tampering a file. Okay, third, giving a new name to a file folder. That term refers to rename. Okay, children, rename means to give new name to a file folder. Fourth one, shifting a file to a new location. Now, children, in this, you can write two options like moving a file or drag and drop. But it is better to write down moving a file. Okay, because drag and drop, if you want to apply a drag and drop technique for this, so we have to make sure that the file which is to be moved and the place where the file is to be shifted, that both should be on the same screen. Okay, but if you want to shift a file from its location to a new location, means to a new window, by opening a new window, then that is referred as moving a file. So it's better to write down it as a moving a file. Okay, just leave that drag and drop, because that for that we should make sure that the screen, that the file which is to be moved and the place where we want to move that file should be on the same screen. Okay, so for this you have to make sure that particular point. So write down moving a file. Now fifth part, making space free on the hard disk to keep more files by the user. That is also referred as deleting a file, because when we delete a file, that makes the space free for storing the new files or for storing the new folders. Okay, children, so removing a file or making space free on the hard disk to keep more files, they both are referred as deleting a file. Okay, children, now read, go through this question answers, just understand them, watch the video again and again, and try to understand the explanations which I have explained over here and learn the question answers. Okay, children, because these kind of questions will come in your exam as multiple choice questions are there. Okay, so this part, this objective part is very, very important for you all. Okay, so learn this question answers. Now, from 15th assignment onwards till 25th assignment, the paper will come, the second term exam will come. Okay, the syllabus for second term exam will come from 15th homework till 25th homework. Okay, children. So, this is enough for today. I'll be taking your leave. We'll be meeting soon in the next video. Till then, stay safe and stay home with a beautiful smile on your face. So, bye, children.